My name is Rocky Herron. I spent 31 years as a special agent for the DEA, the United States Drug Enforcement Administration. Trying to stop drug traffickers at the local, national, and international levels.
And this is us getting stuck in the piranha and alligator infested waters.
I saw too many beautiful people just like you lose their lives or the quality of their lives because they didn't understand the consequences of abusing drugs and alcohol. Today, I use those experiences as a basis for teaching young people like you the hard truth about substance abuse will do to you and your dreams and your futures, hoping that some of you are listening and that some of you will make better choices. Today, we will talk about how drugs and alcohol harm and change the growth and development of teenagers and young adults who go down the road of substance abuse. Adults who abuse substances run the risk of overdose and addiction and emotional harm to themselves and those around them. You run additional risks as your brains and bodies are still trying to grow. The old TV ad of, quote, "this is your brain on drugs" is funny and maybe didn't convince a lot of people, but it's not wrong either.
Okay, last time. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
Science is proving that your brain continues to grow and develop all through your teen years and into the 20s. Your brain is the most important organ in the body. All your other organs keep you alive and let you move around. Your brain makes you who you are. Every memory, every emotion, every dream, every part of your personality and intelligence is from your brain, and it operates on extremely complicated chemical processes. In fact, it's so complicated, scientists still don't completely understand how it works. Drugs and alcohol are chemicals we put in our bodies by snorting, injecting, swallowing, drinking, to get those chemicals into the brain to change how it works. That's what getting drunk or high is. You successfully altered your brain function with the drugs and alcohol. Science is now showing what you do to your own brain development when you use alcohol and drugs. There are now millions of young adults in their 20s and 30s who abused drugs and alcohol while they were teenagers, and scientists can study them. And the science is proving over and over again how dangerous that early drug use is. Again, adults who abuse drugs and alcohol run the risks of overdose and addiction and emotional harm. You run an extra risk. Between the ages of 11 and 25, your brain is going through its period of greatest development. And when it stops growing, that's the brain you're gonna have for life. I am not a scientist, so I don't want you to take my word for it. I want you to hear from my friend, Dr. Natalie Laub, a pediatrician and an expert on youth brain development.
Marijuana products are not safe for the developing teenage brain. So I treat a lot of teenagers in my practice as a pediatrician. And I have a lot of conversations about marijuana and about the effects of marijuana on the developing brain. And one thing teens say to me all the time is, "I smoke marijuana. I take marijuana. It's not a big deal. I feel fine. I am fine." And what I say to them is, what you can't see is what's happening on the inside. The teenage brain is still developing. In fact, brains in humans aren't fully developed until about the age 25. So, what happens to a teenage brain? The parts of the brain in a teenager that are especially immature are the frontal cortex, which is right here, and also the prefrontal cortex, which is on the inside. This part here is the part that's most immature and most vulnerable to the effects of marijuana. So the prefrontal cortex in teenagers, which is still developing, is where marijuana becomes a problem. So it becomes a problem because of the endocannabinoid system, a complex network of synapses, of connections. The endocannabinoid system is in our brain and it's in the rest of our body. And this system is responsible for a lot of things. This system is responsible for memory, attention, concentration, emotions, anxiety, depression, regulating all of these emotions, keeping us in balance. The active ingredient in most marijuana products is tetrahydrocannabinol, or THC. THC mimics, it looks like, the natural chemicals that exist in our endocannabinoid system. So when a teenager ingests marijuana, whether they eat it, smoke it, or drink it, THC floods the brain. It overwhelms the endocannabinoid system. It confuses it. And suddenly the endocannabinoid system in the developing brain cannot function like it's supposed to. It gets confused by the high potency marijuana products that they are being consumed. And when it gets confused over time, over and over and over again, it starts to develop abnormally. You can't regulate your mood or emotions or interact with the world in a meaningful way. And this is why it is so dangerous when teenagers use marijuana products. You probably now know more about the developing brain and the endocannabinoid system than you ever wanted to know. But if you only take one thing away from this entire video, this is what I want it to be. It may not seem like it's a big deal to do cannabis when you're a teenager. It's actually going to have lifelong consequences that could affect you well into adulthood.
As Dr. Laub just explained to you, you can't see what a damaged brain looks like. So let me show you. In these images, we see scans of living human brains showing blood flow. On top, we see scans of someone not under the influence of any drugs or alcohol. But as we go around the diagram, we see scans of people using marijuana, tobacco, opioids, meth, and alcohol. The dark spots on those scans aren't dead parts of their brains. They simply show areas with reduced blood flow. Using the substances has changed the blood flow in their brains, and the dark areas aren't working as they should be. Now, if we look at that 17-year-old weed smoker, we see numerous dark spots. That 17-year-old can't see those, but science can. If we ask a 17-year-old if they're damaging themselves by smoking weed, they'll laugh and say no. They think the question is ridiculous. With all that life wisdom and scientific knowledge they have at 17 years old, they're convinced they aren't damaging themselves. But science shows us differently. If that teenager keeps using it, the marijuana that is stopping those parts of the brain from working is also going to keep those parts of the brain from developing normally. We don't know if that damage is reversible or is permanent. Every drug we put into our bodies causes a reaction within the brain and the body. The brain and the body recognize them as foreign substances, and they do what they can to clear them out of your bodies. As people use alcohol and drugs, the body's responses mean that the people using the substances need to use more to feel the same effect. This is called tolerance, and is true of almost all drugs. Eventually, the use of the substances has changed the body so much that when the person tries to stop using the substances, the body enters a condition called withdrawal, which is a sickness that causes a range of symptoms from anxiety, nausea, fever, and even severe pain. It is the fear of going into withdrawal sickness that takes over the lives of substance abusers, and they will do almost anything to avoid going in withdrawal. They won't be looking out for their bodies, they won't be looking out for their families, they won't be taking care of the important parts of their lives. They just need to keep using the substances. And I know too many of you have been victims of that. I hope you all know you have unique fingerprints. There are more than 7 billion humans on our planet, and each one has a unique fingerprint. And you all have something else that is unique, your brain chemistry. Every one of us will have a different reaction to different medicines, illegal drugs, and alcohol, because we all have unique brain chemistry and physiology. And science is studying why some people become addicted to drugs more quickly and more severely than other people. This is called predisposition to addiction, and it's a risk we all have. You may have seen friends using drugs and alcohol and may seem to be fine, but that does not mean that you'll be fine if you use those same substances. Your body might have a very different reaction. None of us knows what drugs and alcohol will do to us before we start using them. Scientists used to think that our DNA, the blueprint for our growth and development that we received from our biological parents, was fixed and unchangeable. Now there is a new field of science called epigenetics, which looks at how the environment around us changes how our DNA and how our genes express themselves. And today, scientists are producing lots of research showing that young people like you, when you consume drugs and alcohol, are changing how those genes express themselves in your bodies. This means you are changing how your body is physically developing in a permanent way. You can't see it, as this change is invisible to you and happens within your cells. but it could be causing long-term and serious harm to your future health. My children are all adults now, but trying to parent and guide them as teenagers and young adults taught me how much more complicated the world is for you than it was for me when I was your age. When I was young, we didn't have the phones, the internet, social media, hundreds of channels on TV, and we certainly weren't exposed to the super powerful and dangerous drugs that you are. You are being constantly bombarded with information and influences in ways that we adults can't begin to understand. Those influences have changed all of you. Some of those changes have been very positive and beneficial, giving you access to communication and information like never before. But unfortunately, some of those changes have had very negative consequences in you. In fact, your generation is being very closely studied. We are discovering more anxiety and depression and loneliness in your generation than we've ever had in this country before. If you are feeling lonely or sad or anxious, you are not alone. I think that many of those negative changes are happening because the phones have changed how you communicate and share. In the pre-smartphone times, we were forced to talk to each other when we had downtime. But many teens today spend all their time in their phones, and they don't even know how to have genuine conversations with friends. I am guilty of this. I worked too hard in my job and my career, and I was away from my family too much. And even when I was home, I often had my mind in my phone and my work and not focused on my kids. I have huge regrets about that. I know many of your parents are making the same mistake. Social media has taught you many things, but one of the most impactful is that you can't be vulnerable. You don't share the hard parts of your life on social media. Almost no one does, because it can be used against you by bullies, and because it may seem to you that everyone else on social media has a perfect life. Too many young people feel that they may be the only one with problems. That is such a mistake. Every young person in the history of the world has at times felt anxiety and low self-esteem and depression. Those are normal parts of life and of the hard process of growing from children into young adults. You have to learn how to overcome them in healthy ways so you can go build the happy and fulfilling lives you want and deserve. Life is hard and confusing, and it always has been. It's part of the human experience to learn how to cope and overcome our challenges and obstacles by using our natural gifts and talents. Sadly, too many young people today think they can find solutions for those problems by using drugs and alcohol. My life experience has shown me that that is simply a path to additional pain and suffering. Please don't make the mistake that so many make every day. If you've been making mistakes, it's not too late. You can make different choices. You have the power to choose. My goal in doing my teaching is simple. It's to get you to see the truth. Too many times I have to listen to young people share with me their stories of their own pain and suffering from their drug abuse or their suffering from someone else's drug abuse. I need you to care. And you start caring by protecting yourself and working to protect your friends. After hearing this message, none of you will ever be able to tell yourselves or anyone else that you didn't know the harm that would come to you and your friends from using drugs and alcohol. I won't be with you at the party or the beach or the friend's house when someone offers you a pill or a powder or a crystal that could kill you or take control of you. You're going to be the one to make that choice, and you will be the one having to deal with the consequences. In our next video, we're going to take a closer look at some of the most commonly abused substances. Remember, none of us knows what drug abuse will do to us before we start. You choose your futures.